Once again, it's important to remember that the opposite of taking the square root of both sides is to do an exponent, or raise both sides of the equation to an exponent. With even roots, we must check the answer in the original equation. This is called checking for extraneous solutions. Recall that a plus b quantity squared is the same as a squared plus 2ab plus b squared. In example 1, notice that we have x equal to something that's under a square root. If we raise both sides of the equation to an exponent, that's performing the opposite operation, and the square root goes away, and we get x squared is equal to 5x plus 24. Now we can solve for x by setting this whole thing equal to 0 and factoring. Setting my equation equal to 0, I get x squared minus 5x minus 24 equals 0. I can now factor this. And fortunately, this one is easy enough that I don't have to use the quadratic formula. Negative 8 and positive 3 will give me the proper factors to be able to solve this equation. Setting my factors equal to 0, I get x minus 8 is equal to 0, and x plus 3 is equal to 0. At this point, solving for x, I get x is equal to 8 and x is equal to negative 3. Now I have to check for extraneous solutions, or solutions that don't make this equation true. This first value, 8, I'll go ahead and plug in to see what happens. When I plug that in, I get 8 is equal to 40 plus 24, which is the square root of 64. So we can check to see if these are true, and yes indeed, 8 is equal to 8, and so this is not an extraneous solution. Now let's check x is equal to negative 3. If we plug negative 3 in for x, we get negative 3 is equal to the square root of 5 times negative 3 plus 24. When we solve these, or simplify these, we should get negative 3 is equal to negative 3. But when we simplify the radical further, we get negative 15 plus 24. Which is positive 9 inside the radical. When you take the square root of 9, you get 3. Notice that we did not end up with an identity, or the negative 3 equaling a negative 3. This is not a true statement, and so negative 3 is thrown out. In the second example, we're going to raise both sides of the equation to the second power to perform the opposite operation and get rid of the radical sign. Now we have 40 minus 3x is equal to 4x squared minus 20x plus 25. Remember, it's important to foil this before you go any further because of the square root. Subtracting 40 from both sides and adding 3x to both sides I now have 4 x squared minus 17x minus 15 is equal to 0. Now I need to factor that, and I get 4x plus 3 and x minus 5 equals 0. Now I'm going to set my factors equal to 0 and solve for x. I get x is equal to negative 3/4 and x is equal to 5. Now I have to check for any extraneous solutions. Substituting negative 3/4 in for x, I get the square root of 40 minus 3 times negative 3/4. We need to see if that is equal to 2 times negative 3/4 minus 5. The square root of 40 plus 9/4, and we get negative 3/2 minus 5. I'm building up my different denominators. I get 160 plus 9 over 4. That's in square roots. We need to know if that's equal to negative 3 minus 10 over 2. So we're going to have 169 over 4 in square roots. Is that equal to negative 13/2? Well, I can tell you right now that it's going to be 13/2, but that does not equal negative 13/2. So this is not true, and we can't use negative 3/4. On the other side, if we substitute 5 in, we're going to get the square root of 40 minus 3 times 5. And we're checking to see if that's equal to 2 times 5 minus 5. So we get the square root of 40 minus 15, and is that equal to 5? 40 minus 15 is 25. And that is indeed equal to 5. So we can keep this solution right here.